English for the benefit of those who do not understand their needs. This press conference has been arranged because so many people have asked me how I assess the first year of my release from detention. And since it would have been very difficult for me to meet all the journalists individually, I thought it would be much more convenient for everybody concerned if we were to arrange a press conference. Looking back on the past year, I think I can say that it has been eventful, energizing, and to a certain extent, encouraging. This time last year, when I spoke to the public for the first time, I spoke of my intention to form a network for democracy. This network has been one of the great successes of the past year, because this has expanded and we have been able to carry out a lot of work in the field of education, health, humanitarian aid, and other social and economic activities. Of course, the National League for Democracy is a political organization, and because of that, we've always put our political agenda at the forefront. For the past 2.5 decades, or nearly 2.5 decades, we have called for peaceful negotiations to settle the problems of our country. I can say that to a certain extent, we have made some progress in this matter because, as I think all of you probably know, I've met with Minister Urangji several times and with President Uthing Sin once. During those meetings, we have been able to talk about the matters on which we could cooperate and of other matters on which we hope to be able to cooperate more fully as we learn to work together. Now, an issue which has been of great importance to all of us who are working for democracy in Burma is that of political prisoners. Some have been released over the last year, but there are still many who remain in prison. The exact numbers are a matter of controversy. We have our own list, the government has its own list, and other prisoners' associations have their own lists. We have put out our list, which consists of 525, and if you're interested in a copy, perhaps you will ask to speak to Daw Aung after the conference. There are rumors, of course, that important political prisoners are going to be released today, but so far these remain only rumors. We do not have any specific information on who has been released, if anybody has been released at all. Another issue which we consider of very great importance to our country is, of course, the matter of internal peace. We are very concerned about hostilities which have broken out in various parts of Burma, particularly now in the Kachin state. And we hope that the present problems will be settled peacefully. In July, I issued an open letter addressed to the President Uthing Sin and to various ethnic organizations asking for a ceasefire and for peaceful negotiations and offering my services if they should be of any use to the process. This offer still stands. Any time that any of those involved in internal strife in our country would wish me or the NLD to serve in some capacity as a negotiator or as a facilitator, we would be only too willing. Another issue which we think in the long run is actually, or shall I say that I think is actually the most important for our country, is rule of law. Because whether it's a case of political prisoners or it's a case of ethnic strife within the country or whether it's a matter of economic and social development, without the rule of law we cannot really hope to progress. If there is no rule of law, we cannot be sure that there will be no political prisoners in the future. Human rights have to be protected by rule of law. And in the same way, investment and economic opportunities need to be protected by the rule of law. Without such protection, we can never be sure that progress will be sustainable. This is why the NLD has repeatedly spoken of the necessity for rule of law. As many of you are doubtless aware, the National Assembly has passed a number of new laws which have yet to be implemented. But in the implementation of such laws, again, rule of law is important. And rule of law depends on an independent and clean judiciary. This is what we are in great need of for our country now and always in the future, if we are to build up strong democratic institutions. Moving on from the political to the more specific issues, the generally political to the more specific issues relating to the National League for Democracy, we shall be holding a meeting of the Central Committee on the 18th to decide on matters relating to party registration and the coming by-elections. The National Assembly lately passed, and the President has already signed, amendments to the registration and election laws. And in view of these amendments, we are going to reconsider the position that we took in 2010 with regard to registration and the contesting of elections. I had better warn you that I will not be answering any questions related to this subject, so I would like to request you not to spend time on such matters, because I shall only say please wait until the 18th. And I don't think that's the kind of answer that you're looking for. In the role of social and humanitarian work, it has been very encouraging, especially in the matter of education. The network has managed to establish about 16 free schools all over the country within the last 9 months. And these are free schools are totally free. We don't ask for any fees under any kind of heading. The children who come to our schools are the most deprived, and so far as we can see, both parents and children are pleased with what we have been able to offer them. And there have been courses by the VEDA organization put for older people, young people, but older than school age. This is part of our capacity building program for the whole country. The NLD Women's Wing has also been engaging in certain educational and cultural activities. For example, recently we had a short course of backstrap loom weaving in order to uphold the traditions of kitchen weaving, which we are in danger of losing. And the Women's Wing has also engaged in such small enterprises as microcredit financing with street vendors in two bazaars in Rangoon. These are very, very small ventures, but the success with which we have been able to achieve has encouraged us, and we think that with greater opportunities, we shall be able to take our country forward. Now, all of you are probably going to ask me whether I think that we are really firmly now on the road to democracy. I think we can say that we are looking at the opening to the road to democracy, and we all need to work together with faith and daring both. We need to have faith, but we also need to have a bit of daring in order to proceed along this path. There has been some discussion as to whether we should think of the glass as half full or half empty. I think that words like full and empty are rather emotive, and I would rather stick to specifics. What actually has been achieved during the past year, and how much importance should be put on such achievements? Now, these you probably all have your own ideas on, and you will probably wish to ask me questions on specific matters that you see as either progress or non-progress. I myself believe that if we all are determined to go forward and to take a positive view of developments, even if they are not as satisfactory as we would wish these to be. In fact, I'm rather wary of using the word satisfactory or satisfaction, because that smacks a little bit of complacency. And complacent we certainly cannot afford to be at this juncture. We have to understand that there's still a lot of work to be done, and not just work in the sense of physical or mental labor, but work in the sense of trying to create an atmosphere within which cooperation can flower. That is not always easy. We have to be aware of our own prejudices as well as the prejudices of those who are working against us. And we have to try to arrange things so that there isn't such a thing as them and us and for and against, but all working together towards a common national goal. I think what we are trying to achieve is shared commitments to those values which will make our country a strong democratic union where all ethnic nationalities can be safe, secure, and prosperous together on a basis of mutual faith and understanding. This has always been our goal, and this will always remain our goal, because I'm sure the media, more than any other organization, not that the media is an organization, but the media are probably very aware of the fact that there is no such thing as the end to political endeavor, or social endeavor, or economic endeavor for the matter. In fact, there will never be an end to human endeavor. And as we proceed towards a nation where our people can realize their potential, we have to be aware of the fact that this will be an all-time work, forever and ever, as long as our country exists and as long as the world exists. So when you come up with questions, I hope that you will keep in mind what I've already said, that I certainly do not think we have come to the end of our road, or that we shall ever come to the end of our road, because nation building gradually builds up, not to just mere nation building, but nation stabilizing and sustainability. So ours is a long-term venture, I should say. And in this venture, I would like to invite all of you who bear goodwill towards Burma and its people and towards our aspirations to help us by criticizing us when necessary, encouraging us at the right time, and if I may request it, providing us with practical help when we need it. Thank you.
ဒီတနေ့အတွင်းမှာပါမနေ့ကဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ကျမတို့မြောက်လာတဲ့တနေ့ပြည်တွေကြီးပါပဲအဲ့တော့ကျမတို့အနေနဲ့ဒီတနေ့အတွင်းကိုကျမတို့ဘာလို့ဖြစ်မြောက်ခဲ့လဲဆိုတာကိုအဓိကထားပြီးတော့သိချင်ကြတယ်လို့ကျမတို့ချင်ပါတယ်အဲ့တော့ကျမတို့အနေနဲ့ဒီတနေ့ရှင်နေပွဲမှာစဉ်းစားတာဒီတနေ့အတွင်းကိုကျမတို့ဘာလို့ဖြစ်မြောက်ခဲ့လဲဆိုတာကိုအဓိကထားပြီးတော့သိချင်ကြတယ်လို့ကျမတို့ချင်ပါတယ်အ
က်တဲ့လမ်းစဉ်နဲ့ဒီမိုကရေစီလားရရှိရေးအတွက်ဆွေးနွေးညှိနှိုင်းမှုတွေပြင်ပဖို့လုပ်မယ်ဆိုပြီးတော့ကျမတို့ငှချရတာဒီတိုင်းတိုင်းကျမတို့ဟာ20ရောဒီလမ်းကိုရှောက်ခဲ့ပါတယ်အခုညမှာဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ထူးထူးခြားခြားနိုင်ငံရေးဖြစ်စဉ်တွေလို့ပြောရမယ်ဆိုရင်က ဒီမှာလေဟိုတမန်ရင်းသိစေဝင်ကြီးဟောကြီးတို့တွေ့ဆုံမှုတွေကရရရအပြောင်းအလဲတွေရှိခဲ့ပါတယ်။အများအခုစင်စိတ်ဝင်စားနေတာတော့
ဒီမိုကရေစီအဲ့အတွက်မရှိမဖြစ်ရှိရမယ်ကိစ္စအခုဖြစ်ပါတယ်ဒီမိုကရေစီအစအဆောက်အဦးနေခိုင်မာဖို့ဆိုတာဟာလွတ်လပ်လမ်းမှာရှိနေတဲ့တရားရေးမှန်တိုင်ဟာအကြီးအကျယ်ဖြစ်ပါတယ်အဲ့တော့အဲ့ဒီဟာအတွက်ကျမတို့ဟာဆက်ပြီးတော့ကြိုးစားသွားပါမယ်ဆိုတာလည်းကျွန်တော်ပြောချင်ပါတယ်ကျမတို့အရင်နှစ်ကကျမတို့ဒီလိုနေ့မှာပေါ့နော်ဆက်လေးနေ့မှာရုပ်ရှင်မှာဒီလိုနဲ့ကြားပြောတဲ့
ကျမတို့ကယုံကြည်ချက်ပေါ်မှာအခြေခံပြီးတော့စွန့်စားနေတဲ့အချိန်မှာလဲစွန့်စားရပါမယ်။အဲ့ဒီလိုတော့မှသာနေတယ်ကျမတို့တို့ချင်းတဲ့ဒီမိုကရေစီလမ်းကြီးကဖွင့်သွားမှာပါ။ဒီတော့မဖွင့်သားမဖွင့်သေးဘူးလားလို့တချို့ကပြောနေတယ်။ဒီလိုကျမပြောခြင်းအပြင်ဒီမိုကရေစီလမ်းကြီးကမဖွင့်သေးဘူးလားလို့ပြောတာလားဆိုလို့ရှိရင်ဒီလမ်းကဖွင့်ပြီးလို့အားလုံးကနေပြီးတော့လက်ခံနိုင်တဲ့အချိန်ကြီးတော့မရောက်သေး